What is up, you guys? This is the White Rabbit, and welcome back to Mortal Kombat Deadly Alliance. Where, I think, I don't even know who to start with. You know what, let's go Katana. Because why not? We'll go Katana this time, and, you know, we'll go from there. Katana has for many years been at war with the Emperor Shao Kahn. She has proven herself to be a great leader and diplomat after allying with the Shokans in a massive strike against the Emperor and his armies. Though she is a great warrior, it is her grace in combat that you must learn to emulate. Brute strength alone will not win the fight. The Eagle Claw system of Kung Fu used by Katana originated in southern China during the Song Dynasty around the year 1250 AD. It was brought to Outworld a few centuries later by an unnamed martial art master. Which, I think with current timeline, would that be Liu Kang? Who knows? Years ago, Katana had used her skills to negotiation to bring about a truce between Prince Goro and Kung Lao. Practiced Katana's Eagle Claw basic high attacks with Kung Lao. Okay. Kung Lao is getting worked. Katana's Eagle Claw lifting kick pop-up allows her to pop her opponent into the air long enough to execute another attack. Practice the lifting kick, yes. Let me guess, I have to do that two more times. Well done. Now execute Katana's lifting kick pop-up attack, and while Kung Lao is still in the air, execute it two more times. Yeah, that's pretty much what I expected. Pretty much. Excellent. Katana uses her Eagle Claw low attacks to keep her opponent on edge. By altering between her high and low attacks, her opponent never knows where her attacks will come from. I guess that's true? Thought I heard something. Katana's Sidestep Claw 3D attack serves to confuse her opponent as well as inflict damage. It is also a very useful dodge or escape move. Ow. Come on. One more. There we go. I don't like it when they move. While in the Eagle Claw fighting style, Katana can shove a blocking opponent. The heck was that? That. What the heck was that? My head is getting too warm in this beanie. Ah, that's better. You ever wear a hat for so long and then your head just starts to feel warm? Like, the rest of your body's fine, but it's just your head. Princess Katana was at war with the Emperor of Outworld, Shao Kahn. She had joined forces with Prince Goro of the Shokan and was effectively confronting Kano's troops. Although victory seemed attainable, Katana did not know how long her troops could sustain the attack. Bagua Zhang, translated to 8 Trigram Palm, is a relatively new Chinese martial art. Having been developed in the late 1800s, Bagua Zhang was developed by Dong Hai Chuan, a Taoist of the Longmen, Dragon Gate sect. The circular movements of the art are attributed to the circular chanting meditations done by the Longmen sect. Starting in the early 1900s, Ba Guazhong has been associated with Sing I, or Sing First. I don't know. It's hard to pronounce words that I've never seen before. Execute Katana's Bagua high attacks on Shao Kahn's general Kano. Really? You do all these big lunging attacks, and then it's just pih. While in Bagua fighting style, Katana can do two pop-up attacks called Hammer, Palm Strike, and Horse Kick. Okay. You didn't teach me the other one. Why didn't you teach me the other one? Good. Now execute two more times. Alrighty. Next, you will try the same attack with the Horse Kick pop-up. Pop Kano into the air with execute the Horse Kick two more times to juggle him. Okay. Why, though? That is my main question through all this. Why? Well done. Now for Katana's basic Bagua low attacks. Okay. At least they're getting more consistent where they're actually attacking the legs instead of the abdomen. To quickly distance herself from our opponent, Katana can escape with Bagua backflip. You know what? Fair enough. Outstanding. Indeed. Fair enough. She can escape with those moves. I'm hoping by the end of this one, we'll be able to get either... Who was it? Natara or Draman. The base camp of Katana's military forces was hidden in a valley on the eastern side of the Outworld Plains. Further to the east were the vampire people. Occasionally, lookouts would spot a female vampire watching the camp from a rocky outcropping. All attempts to capture the vampire proved to be futile. Katana is renowned throughout Edenia for her proficiency in the steel fan fighting style. What did her steel fans have to do with the story? Attack the vampire, Natara, with Katana's steel fan high attacks. Once again, I fail to see what her steel fan fighting style has to do with Natara. Katana can perform a pop-up attack on her opponent with her steel fans called the Sky Strike. Okay. Do I have to do that two more times after this? Execute the steel fan pop-up attack and then follow two more. Yep. It gets predictable, I guess. Attacking Tar with Katana low attacks. Like, I didn't want to use the word predictable, but that's what it is at the end of the day. It's predictable. They have the same stuff. Adding versatility to Katana's steel fan fighting style, the sidestep swing acts as both an evasive move and offensive. Okay, now what? We've done everything with the fans I can think of. Katana can impale. Oh, once the steel fans are impaled, however, can't get them again. I'm sorry? I didn't know that was a thing. I mean, I have to remember that. That's a useful attack. Just throw the fans. And even if you miss, they'll come back. I think. Yes? The combined forces of Katana and Goro made one last push against Kano's troops, but were unsuccessful in breaching his line of defense. though Kano's army was fewer in number than the united armies of Edinia and the Shokan, it seemed as though they were being strengthened by some unseen force. Tragically, near the end of that skirmish, Prince Goro was fatally injured. His men brought him back to the encampment where Kitana stayed by his side until he passed. That took a dark twist very quickly. I don't even know how to feel about that. By combining multiple strikes into one long attack, Kitana can more effectively combat her opponent. Yeah. That, yeah. I mean, that's kind of a no-brainer. Well done, but Kano is not defeated yet. Execute these more advanced combos to defeat him. What the? There we go. Why is this one more advanced?
Excellent.
Why is that one more advanced? Ooh, more gold. I ought to be keeping track of how much gold I have, solely so I know when we're closer to getting the character. Much to Kitana's disbelief, Kano's forces retreated. Word started to spread that the Emperor, Shao Kahn, had been slain by unknown assassins. It seemed as though Kitana had won. Yeah, unknown assassins. The assassins were well known to Shao Kahn. Well, I mean, I guess they would have to be if they killed him. Attack Kano with Kitana's Bagua combo 2 times. Okay. I'm waiting for one of these missions just to be one mission, and that's it. Kano is far from surrendering. You must utilize Kitana's more advanced steel fan combos. Bootlicker. Those aren't that difficult, I guess. They're not necessarily easy. Sapphire. We need sapphire. We need those. They're not necessarily easy, but, you know, they're not the hardest thing. While returning to the portal back to Edinia, Kitana happened upon Kung Lao, who was traveling alone. It was through Kung Lao that she learned of the Deadly Alliance and the death of Liu Kang at the hands of Shang Tsung. It seemed that her return home would have to wait. Now she's going after Shang Tsung and Quan Chi, and everything's gonna be hunky-dory! Practice Kitana's pretty kick with Kung Lao to prepare for the battle to come. Okay. Kung Lao will put you to the test this time and fight back. Yeah. Seemed like he really fought back. No, I don't need jade. I need gold and sapphire. Those are the two I need. As Kitana's army was breaking camp, there was a loud ruckus of combat from the northern flank. A reptilian creature was angrily attacking her men. Though her soldiers were able fighters, they were no match for the savage creature and were easily taken down. Kitana had to move quickly to prevent further harm and destruction. Leave Reptile alone, okay? Reptile has had enough happen to him to warrant at least one ramble and, you know, unearthly attack. Really? No. Reptiles had enough happen to him.
Let's see, the reptilian creature has now focused its attention on you. Levitate it with Katana's fans 3 more times.
Well done. Reptile, you deserve much better than what happened to you.
200 more gold!
I'm excited. We're getting closer to a new character.
The reptilian creature had fled to the east, and Katana's camp was secure once more. She gave her military commanders orders to remain at the camp until she returned from an excursion with Kung Lao. They were both in need of special martial arts training from Outworld Master Bo Rai Cho. Once they had found Bo Rai Cho, he trained them in the fighting techniques they wished to learn. Katana's training encompassed style branch attack combos. When she learned to combine her fighting styles into one long attack combination, her combative effectiveness increased.
Great! I very much dislike the combos. Because... Well, I don't need a reason, I just dislike them. For that exact reason. I hate that they're so long.
Now Master Bo Rai Cho will test what you have learned. Execute the Lost Love Style branch combo.
I just did that! I just did that combo. What the heck? No, I don't need ruby. I need gold and sapphire.
Katana and Kung Lao finally confronted the deadly alliance in Shang's palace. While Kung Lao faced off with Shang Tsung, Katana engaged Quan Chi in mortal combat. The battle was intense. Katana had never confronted an opponent quite like Quan Chi before, and had to call upon all her martial arts training to defeat him.
Is it gonna be more combos? Or is it gonna be like a trial of blood? Round one. Nope, it's just a fight. Win 2 out of 3. Got him midair. I think that's how I'm gonna win. It's just the fans. Round two. Fight. Whoop. Oh wait, are the fans like completely gone now? Oh, she doesn't even have the fan lift attack anymore. No, don't do that. You're supposed to be on the ground.
Superb.
Come on, gold or sapphire? Gold! Come on, do we have enough to get a new character? I hope.
Most impressive. You've learned much through your journey. You have mastered many fighting styles and beaten many opponents, but there is one opponent you still need to confront.
Completely different situation. Your final test will be a mirror image of Katana. Of course it will. Of course it will. 3 out of 5. Because, you know, why not? Round one. Fight! Yeah! Come on. I really don't have much to say. Katana wasn't ever my pick of fighter. Like, I have nothing against her. She was just never my choice of fighter. Scorpion was my guy. Or is my guy. I don't know why I said was. Scorpion is always the main guy that I fight with. Which is why he's 9 times out of 10 the guy I get the stuff for first. So, like, I will always get his story done first, and then I'll move on to the ones I dislike.
Outstanding.
Come on, Gold or Sapphire. Congratulations. Thank you. Gold! I'm sorry. Come on, save faster. Okay. Going to the crypt. Because I think we have enough for a new character. I think. I could be wrong. I think we have enough. The crypt. Let's see. Natara. T-I. Let's see. G-H-I. O-P-Q-R-S-T. Whew. And then we're so close to the other one. Natara. Alright, with that, I'm gonna leave this one here. So thank you guys so much for watching this one. If you liked it, you know what to do. Keep things crazy, and I'll see you guys in the next one.